Good afternoon, good morning, hello, and welcome back to another video. It's another challenge video, and I have been, so my excuse for this one is I've been Googling a lot of footballers' diets, football players' training, and what they do to obviously become really fit. One of them being Cristiano Ronaldo. He's got, you know, really good diet plan. He's just the fittest out there. It came to my mind, kick-ups. It's something I can't do. It's something I definitely cannot do. I just thought, try and do something that is actually gonna be a challenge. I gave myself 6 days. You'll see how bad I am. Literally, I'm just gonna train, practice, and just see how good, if I can even do any, in 6 days. See how far I can get in 6 days. And if I can do 10, I will be a happy lady. So I hope you enjoy the video. Keep watching to find out if I actually manage it. So if you haven't already, please like, and let's see if I can do it. So our actual half decent footballs are outside in the garden and getting wet, so the only balls we have in the house is Toy Story. So this is just to show you how bad, not even joking, this is me trying to do kick-ups. As you can see, I am really, really bad at kick-ups. I can maybe hit the first one, but I don't know how to. Obviously, there's some art. You've got to keep it going up straight, and I haven't learned that yet. So, yeah, it's going to take a while. I've done some Googling, and apparently, to start with kick-ups, you need to learn how to maybe first try doing it on your knee. So like on your thigh, so I might start there. Oh, it's just gonna take a while. I need the grey ball. So I just want to say here, like you can see that I'm starting to get a little bit more control over the ball. I'm still obviously losing it quite a lot, but I'm actually now like making the ball go where I want it to go a bit more. Update. It's really echoey in here. Right, update. I'm all wonky on the PIS here. Right. Update, day number 4, and I can honestly say I've improved. I feel I've improved. Day one was literally, if the ball touched my foot, it went that way, that way, that way, this way. It went everywhere. So I can easily say day one, I could not kick up the ball. And I also started bouncing it off my thigh as well. I could manage one of those to try and get it straight up as well. Obviously a massive improvement. So I'm not rolling the camera all the time because that would just make so much, way too much footage. Yesterday I did manage to do 10 off my thigh. So I did 10 alternate off my thighs and I was absolutely beaming, absolutely beaming when I did that. So really, really pleased with that. Until last night was the first time I actually managed to start kicking the ball with a bit of control, so it wasn't just flying because I've touched the ball. I was controlling it and managing to get it to go up rather than anywhere. So anyway, today I keep practicing. So I've been told by a couple of people to sort of bounce the ball, tap it, bounce, tap. So I've started that and I can now get quite a good rhythm going where I'm sort of juggling the ball with a bounce in between. That is a big improvement. I'm still not at the kick up stage. I have actually done 5 today, all on the same foot. So I've obviously got to stop being so rigid, I think, because I'm so concentrating, I'm not relaxing enough. So I'm not switching feet, which I do need to try and do. I need to be a bit more flexible in what I'm doing. But I managed to do 5 on one foot. Really pleased with that. I notice I go around in a circle a lot. I sort of seem to kick it on my right and sort of go around. I think I did a full 360 when I was doing knee ups yesterday. If I kick the ball, I kick the ball. So I'm pretty happy with that. I'm going to practice for 2 more days. Well, we are now. We're Sunday now. So I'm going to give it to Tuesday. Jamie is at nursery tomorrow. I am literally going to be doing knee up, knee up, knee up, because I want to get on film. I want you guys to see me do 10. I might even need padding tomorrow. Like, my thighs are sore. Like, the ball hits you. Like, it's not obviously heavy and hard, but by the time it's done that so many times, it's really starting to, like, feel a bit tender there. So no pain, no gain. Another thing, so I'm just walking downstairs, and another thing I just wanted to say, when I'm doing my practice, my heart rate clearly goes up because my active minutes yesterday, so my active minutes can range from, depending on what workout I do, but generally say 30 to 36 minutes a day. Yesterday, they've been creeping up over the last couple of days, and yesterday I actually hit 201 active minutes. And that was 40 minutes for the workout. We did a little walk around Holden and the rest of it was kick up practice. So it's a good form of burning those calories. I was absolutely starving last night as well. I ate a bit too much chocolate. If I told you I just did 10 kick-ups without the ball touching the floor, would you believe me?
Yeah.
And I got it on camera.
Have you?
Yeah.
Get in there, mate.
I'll show you it in a minute.
Well good, well good.
update, it is day number 6 and I am definitely no pro. I have a couple of times managed to do 10. So I want to do the consecutive kick up so it doesn't touch the floor. I can do plenty where it bounces on the floor and I touch it and I can keep it going with a bounce in between. But I am struggling to keep it up on my foot. But I think if you go back to day 1, I am a lot better. I have a lot more control of the ball. Sweating. My active minutes has gone up to 72. That's how long I've been out there today. Nearly an hour. I have literally been out there an hour this morning. It doesn't even feel like an hour. It goes so fast. And I must spend about 40 minutes of that chasing the ball. I'm always chasing the ball. So it's definitely safe to say practice every single day and you will get these kick-ups. I had never played football. I never really had any interest in football as such. I don't mind kicking a ball about, but I don't have any control where the ball kicks to. So, and yeah, it just shows that anybody with practice and a little bit of guidance, you can learn to do kick-ups. So you can do anything if you practice. That's what I've learned from this. So now I need to think, what do I need to practice next? What do I want to get good at? So even though now I'm going to obviously stop filming, it's the end of my challenge, I'm still going to carry on doing these kick-ups because, one, I have now decided I want to get 10 kick-ups in a row more often. So I've done it a couple of times out of absolute fluke, but I want to be able to actually control the ball more and do 10 kick-ups in a row, like, you know, without losing the ball. And secondly, I'm absolutely done in. Like, my legs have taken such a battering. It's fun. I'm definitely gonna keep it up. So I'm not gonna become a pro footballer, but I can see what the hype is about a little bit now. So on that okay note, I'm gonna leave it there. I've got a lot of editing to do because I've got a lot of chasing balls to edit out, so I'm not gonna waffle on. So much effort has gone into this video for you guys and for me. So if you've made it this far, thank you for watching my video. Please give it a thumbs up, please subscribe, and I will catch you in another video. Bye.